E-mini S&Ps open up the week moving lower, trading as high as 5213 today, but then reversing and heading to as low as 5094, trading below 5100 for the first time in over a month, ending the session just north of 5100, but still down over 1% on the session. Now, looking back on April 1st, we had our last new all-time high at 5333. Since then, E-minis have sold off about 4 to 4.5%, a lot of that being attributed to the rate cutouts being shifted from first and second quarter out to third and fourth quarter, and the potential for 3 to 4 rate cuts in 2024, now seeing only 1 to 2 rate cuts in 2024. And add to that, over the last week and a half, we've seen an accelerated geopolitical risks in the Middle East, along with headline risks. All of that has put together and seen E-mini sell off over the last couple of sessions, again, seeing a move down to 5,100 today and down over 1% on the session. Now, what does this mean for volatility? Well, looking at volatility, it moves inversely to the indices. So as we saw equities rallying in the first 3 months of this year, volatility was near all-time lows. However, since things have shifted since April 1st, and we've seen a decline in the indices, volatility has been on the rise. It spiked higher on Friday, but did not settle near those highs. Today, we spiked higher back to Friday's highs again, but we did close near those highs today. So saw volatility closing at near a five-month high. Lastly, what do we have tomorrow? Tomorrow is Tuesday. We get some housing data. We have several Fed speakers, of which will be highlighted by Mr. Powell, the Fed chair, who will be speaking at just after noon Central Time, just after 1 o'clock Eastern Time. And then we'll continue to get earnings, which have been coming out. We've had bank earnings that started Friday and today. They have been beating expectations. But really, all eyes could be remaining on the headlines and what the Fed chair says. Clearly, the Fed chair, since the last time we heard him speak at March FOMC, he may have changed his tune given the fact that we've seen an increase in inflation and an increase in economic data. So a lot has maybe changed, and the Fed chair may want to give us his thoughts and about what's happening here as we see equities decline, as we see interest rates rising, and as we see the market readjusting for less Fed rate cuts in 2024. So starting off the week, we see E-mini selling off, trading down to 5,100, down over 1% on the session. Ahead of tomorrow's housing, Fed Chair Powell, and more earnings.